Hey family, I'm Caleb and I love
a good party. You know what I'm talking about? We all get the idea of making some noise for something we like, right? As a matter of fact, I want you to make some noise where you are right now. Come on! I can't hear you. We know what it's like to cheer for our favorite sports team or sing really loud to our favorite song. You know the one. We might even get into trouble for being too loud from time to time. And don't worry, in a few minutes, I'm gonna stop talking and we're gonna keep the party going. But first, I wanna quickly tell you about the first time the Christmas volume went all the way up. We're gonna start in the middle of something incredible that happened, and then we'll talk about how we got there. Cool? Okay, so imagine this. It's ancient times. Shepherds are just hanging out in the fields late at night watching their sheep, minding their own business when this happens. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. I'm sorry, terrified? No kidding. An angel just appeared. What does that even mean? I have no idea what that was like, but I imagine it was bright and loud. I would have been like, yo, every sheep for themselves, I'ma head out. But before the shepherds could run, here's what happened next. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord." This not so silent, super loud announcement of Jesus being born was supposed to be good news, great joy for all people. Guys, it was a big announcement, and it probably felt even bigger to the people back then than it does to us right now. Why? Because the volume had been turned down for so long. People don't always talk about this part of history, but before Jesus was born, the people of Israel had been in constant prayer. Prayer that seemed to go unanswered for 400 years. Say it again, 400 years. They'd been praying for a savior to lead and rule for a very, very, very long time. And even though God was still working, to the people of Israel, it felt like God was silent. That means those shepherds in the field and their parents and their grandparents probably couldn't even remember a time when anybody on the planet had heard from God. And that had to bring up some questions, right? I mean, when a friend doesn't talk to you, you wonder, yo, are they mad at me? Do they still even like me? Do they hate me? Am I in trouble? Are we fighting? I imagine that during those 400 years of praying and not hearing much from God, God's people started to wonder similar things. Like, is God mad at us? Like, are we in trouble? And now, maybe you wouldn't use those same words, but maybe you've had similar questions about God too. Maybe you've wondered, is God mad at me? Maybe you've wondered if there even is a God. And if there is, would God ever want to be cool with you? If you've ever wondered if you're okay with God, you're not alone. There's a good chance that's how most of ancient Israel felt just before this one big moment. Then, out of nowhere, God responded. And God didn't just text them like, "Nah, we're cool." Instead, God sent Jesus. God came in person. Jesus came to make a way for all of humanity to be close to God. This wasn't a message written on an ancient document like you see in a museum. Guys, this was God showing up in person. Sending Jesus was the loudest possible message that God loves us, and nothing will ever change that. But just to make sure that everybody heard the message, the angels announced it too. Good news, great joy, all people. Because of Jesus, one thing was clear that very first Christmas. God has so much love for humanity, and that's still true today. So, if you're here and you've ever wondered if God is mad at you, if God wants you here, or if God would even be friends with you, here's what I want you to know today. We can know God loves us because he sent us Jesus. This is great news because it means the pressure is off. It means you don't have to prove anything for God to be crazy about you. You don't have to be super holy. You don't have to know all the verses or the words to every song. You don't even have to be at church every single week. You don't have to dress a certain way, think a certain way, or act a certain way. If we could make ourselves worthy of God's love, God wouldn't have needed to send Jesus. God would have just waited on us to get our act together. Instead, God made the first move to show us love by sending Jesus to us. And that, my friends, is good news and great joy for all the people. And that is worth turning the volume all the way up.